a woman who's been advocating for peace and women's rights in Yemen, a country where simply speaking about politics is deemed dangerous. And it's because of her work that Hind al-Eryani was forced to move from Turkey to Sweden in search of asylum. The award-winning Yemeni journalist is now being attacked for a piece that she published on homosexuality. Hind, thanks so much for being with us on Middle East Matters. Your piece has triggered an avalanche of criticism.
Thank you for having me. I will tell you the story from the beginning. I was reading this article about the Prime Minister of Finland. It was published by Jaffer Talk program. And they were saying that she was raised in a homosexual family. And I was reading the comments. The comments were like, how come she's not lesbian? How come she's a good woman? So I thought that maybe I should write an article about these misconceptions. And explain to people what is, and the title of my article was "Why Are You Scared of Homosexual People?"
So you were trying to educate, but of course there was a backlash, and that's nothing new. Homosexuality in the region often sparks really spirited debates, and one of the reasons for that is because we are still talking about largely conservative societies. Some of these countries, homosexuality is still punishable by death.
Yeah, of course, in Yemen, it's horrible for anyone to be from the LGBTQ community. They kill them, they torture them, and unfortunately, people, they don't feel bad about that. They don't defend, nobody would defend them. They think that this is the right thing to do. And I'm coming from this society, and I totally understand why people are saying that. And I published a video telling them, I understand why you are mad. Because we were raised, in school, they were telling us that a whole village was punished by God because they were gays. People think that if we accept gays, then everybody will be gay, and then they will not have kids anymore. So I was expecting this from the beginning. When I said this, I was expecting this backlash.
Hind, there are, of course, other issues that are very important to you. You've been very critical in the past of radical views regarding women in Yemen. You've slammed conservative figures who've essentially justified the rape of children in the country. Has your work, do you think, your words actually made any difference up until this stage?
When I put about the girl that was beaten by her father, we were able to treat her sister, who was also beaten by the same father. But in general, I'm focusing on giving awareness to people because every day more and more people, they realize that how it is so unfair. The Yemeni law is unfair when it comes to women and children. So this is the main goal, actually.
I want to stay on that topic. A recent study has actually revealed an increase in violence against both women and children resulting from the conflict in Yemen. How can we explain this?
Yes, that's true. We noticed that every month there is one case of a girl who is, usually there are girls more than boys, are being beaten by the father or killed, or a woman that is killed by her brother or father. So this is increasing, and also the extremist group, the number of extremist groups are increasing, of course, after the war.
And is the violence really directly linked with the rise in the extremist groups?
Not just, it's because, you know, the whole situation is encouraging you to be violent. You don't have salary. The media is all the time telling you to go and kill someone, that you should go to the war, or you can't afford your living. So you become violent. I'm not giving excuses to these people, but this is what's happening. And I think the only solution for this is for this war to stop.
Only solution is for the war to stop. On that note, Hind al-Eryani, I'd like to thank you for taking the time to speak to us about these very important topics on Middle East Matters.